Meghan in woe. Trump jumped down Meghan's throat by her disrespect to Queen and royals. Trump was critical of the Duchess of Sussex in a wide-ranging interview with Nigel Farage where he said that one day Harry will regret the way that his relationship with the rest of the royals has been ruined. It's not the first time Trump has said cruel things about Meghan, who called him divisive and misogynistic during the 2016 presidential campaign. Speaking with former UKIP leader Nigel Farage, Mr. Trump admits he has never been a fan of Meghan, who he believes has used Prince Harry. I think Harry's been used and been used terribly. I think it's ruined his relationship with his family, and it hurts the Queen. Speaking of the Duchess, he added, I think she's been very disrespectful to the Queen, who's such a great woman, such a great person, a historic person. I think she's very disrespectful to the royal family and most importantly to the Queen. He also said that Meghan was very inappropriate when asked by Mr. Farage about claims she used her royal title to meddle in US politics, by writing on the Sussex's headed paper to lobby Congress members on issues such as paternity leave. She is trying to do things that I think are very inappropriate, he said. Mr. Trump also spoke of his fondness for the Queen, claiming he was raised to have respect for the royal family because his mother was from Scotland. During the interview, Trump called the Queen a great woman, such a great person, a historic person. Trump has spoken before of his admiration for the Queen. During his state visit to the UK in summer 2019, Trump praised the royals saying, "The Queen and the entire royal family have been fantastic. The relationship with the United Kingdom is very strong." While at the same time he has been critical of Meghan and Harry on a number of occasions. It is not the first time that Mr. Trump has clashed with the Sussexes. Earlier this year, he said he would campaign for the White House in 2024 if Meghan was joining the race. Mr. Trump was commenting on rumors that the Duchess was meeting with Democrat operatives, and she may want to run. He told Fox News, "I hope that happens because if that happened then I think I'd have an even stronger feeling towards running. I'm not a fan of hers. I've met with the Queen and I think the Queen is a tremendous person and I'm not a fan of Meghan." Last year he again said he was not a fan of Meghan and wished Harry luck, adding, "He's going to need it." Those comments, which were made in September, came after the Sussexes were accused of interfering in the presidential election campaign won by Joe Biden. In what was seen as a thinly veiled swipe at Mr. Trump, they urged voters to reject hate speech, misinformation and online negativity. In 2019, Mr. Trump called the Duchess nasty because of her past criticism of him. The new interview, recorded in Florida on Monday, we'll also see Mr. Trump speak on a range of subjects including the Capitol Hill riot in January and his impeachment trial for allegedly inciting it. The U.S. Senate later acquitted him. He will be asked about climate change and whether he will run for office again, having hinted early this year that he was very seriously considering it. The program, Farage, the Trump interview with the station promising that nothing is off limits. A preview clip with dramatic music shows the duo sitting opposite each other in a grand room with a short quote from Mr. Trump saying, "I think you will be happy in the future too." The friendship between Mr. Farage and Mr. Trump goes back several years. Mr. Farage has said the men have much in common because Trump and I have probably been the most reviled people by the liberal media in the world. The pair have appeared together on stage before with the former UKIP leader speaking at an election rally in Phoenix, Arizona, last October, where Mr. Trump hailed Mr. Farage as the King of Europe. They also held talks in November 2016 which saw Mr. Farage become the first UK politician to meet the US president following his election victory. The U.S. the Queen a great woman, such a great person, a historic person. Trump has spoken before of his admiration for the Queen. During his state visit to the UK in summer 2019, Trump praised the royals, saying, "The Queen and the entire royal family have been fantastic. The relationship with the United Kingdom is very strong." While at the same time he has been critical of Meghan and Harry on a number of occasions. It is not the first time that Mr. Trump has clashed with the Sussexes. Earlier this year, he said he would campaign for the White House in 2024 if Meghan was joining the race. Mr. Trump was commenting on rumors that the Duchess was meeting with Democrat operatives, and she may want to run. He told Fox News, "I hope that happens, because if that happened, then I think I'd have an even stronger feeling towards running. I'm not a fan of hers. I've met with the Queen and I think the Queen is a tremendous person, and I'm not a fan of Meg."